A very warm good morning to all of you. Today, we are going to learn first chapter of life skill, that is, qualities of bright child. Before proceeding further, let us know who is bright child. A bright or an intelligent child is the one who is always aware of what is going around, because he or she is good observant and always helpful. They are well aware about their surroundings. They know what is happening around them. Okay? It is very important to keep yourself updated about your surroundings by reading newspaper, watching TV and surfing the internet. So, how we can be updated? By reading newspaper, by watching television programs such as Discovery, and also by searching on the internet. A bright child is caring, courteous, and works very hard. He or she is self-disciplined. He or she is ready to take initiative to do something. They always want to do something new. Fine. There are some more qualities that are found in a bright child. For example, they are independent. They do not depend on others for their work. They are punctual, they reach school on time, they do their work on time. They are goal-oriented, they have some goal in their life and they work very hard to achieve that goal. They are caring. Of course, we had discussed they are very hardworking, they are alert and also observant. They are very keen observer. They always observe the minute things and learn from them. Moreover, they are courteous too. They are always kind to others. Now, how you can become a bright child? For that, you need to follow certain points. First one is, explore yourself and bring out the best you have. You need to know about yourself and always try to do your best. Behave in such a manner as you are an example to others. When we act as an example to others, we try to do our best. That's why we should always try that we behave in such a manner that as we are example to others. Do not annoy or criticize others. Never criticize or demotivate others. When you criticize others, you criticize yourself also. Take on challenges and create your own path. Every task you get, you should take it as a challenge. For example, if a teacher had selected you for a activity, then you should take it as challenge, even if you don't know about it. And make your own path. Work on creativity, innovation. Practice what you preach. When you give some lesson to others, some advice to others, first practice it yourself. Apply it on yourself. Then only you can give it to others. Cultivate the quality of taking ideas and thoughts of others and implement them into action. That means you should always take ideas from others. You should take their point of view, their view, so that you could get quality matter and you could implement in your daily life. Be ready to assume leadership in all the situation. But that means you should always have leadership qualities on in every situation. Let's see some more points. Mold your thoughts in a right way. If you get negative thought, you should always ignore them. Try to ignore them and develop positive thoughts in your mind. Exhibit initiative in studies and in all the activities. We had already discussed that we should take initiative. We should never wait for others to give us opportunity. We should take initiative in not only in studies but also in other co-curricular activities. Be regular in your work and follow a disciplined life. Always have a discipline in your life. Never wait for someone to watch you. If someone is watching you, you are in a discipline, and if someone is not watching you, you are not in a discipline. That should not be there. You should have a disciplined life. You should have some principles, some ethics in your life, and be regular in your work. Try to be a true and loyal friend. As it is well said that a friend in need is a friend indeed. Right? So we should always try to be loyal to our friends. We should always try to become a true friend. Right? Develop inner qualities and abilities and not merely your physical appearance. We should not only focus on our physical appearance, how we look from outside, but also have some inner qualities, because physical appearance may destroy, but your inner qualities never destroy. Work hard and do your best, as there is no gain without efforts. Yes, we should do our best. We should not think that what will be the result of it, but we should do our best and leave the rest. So this is how you can become a bright child. So there is one activity for you. It is given in your book also. If you answer these questions, that you will come to know whether you have a quality to become, you have a spirit to become a bright child or not. For example, do you come to school on time? If you come on time, then write yes, and if you don't come on time, then write no. If you don't come on time, then which class do you miss? Whether you miss your zero period, in which a teacher conduct your morning assembly, or maybe mind power, maybe your MI club, etc. Do you plan to work and study? Whenever you have you work, you do your homework, you study, do you have any plan or you do it randomly? Do you feel jealous of your friends? Or how success of your friends affect you? You feel happy for them or you become sad? So this was your chapter number 1, how to become a bright child. If you face any query, you can contact to your respective class teachers, and also one PDF is shared to you in your class group. With the help of that, you can complete the back exercise of the chapter. I hope the topic is clear to you. Thank you.